Back pain is one of the most common complaints that patients have when they need a physician. About 25% of Americans have reported at least one episode of back pain in the last 3 months. Is back pain normal? If you are a patient that suffers in pain and has severe morning stiffness for many months, you should watch this video as I'm going to share with you 4 steps that I use to diagnose ankylosing spondylitis. Hi there, I'm Dr. Girnita, and I'm a rheumatologist licensed in multiple US states. I am passionate about educating my patients about their diseases, treatments, and lifestyle medicine. This video is for educational purpose only and will not substitute medical evaluation by a physician. For any medical advice, please consult with your physician. In case of an emergency, please call 911 immediately. These days, 3.2 million adults in the United States suffer with ankylosing spondylitis, or AS, which is the abbreviation that we use for this disease. Unfortunately, ankylosing spondylitis is a disease frequently missed, and patients suffer many years until they come to be seen and evaluated for this disease. Something to remember is that ankylosing spondylitis is a systemic disease that not only affects your spine, but also can affect other joints, tendons, and organs such as your eyes, your lungs, your heart, and your kidneys. Most patients that develop AS are young, and their symptoms start gradually over the course of a few weeks or a few months. If you want to learn more about the most common symptoms of AS, watch this video in my channel. When I evaluate a patient with AS, I do follow 4 steps. These steps were proposed in 2013 by the Spondyloarthritis International Society. Step 1. If a patient is presenting with chronic low back pain, with onset before the age of 45 and persistent for at least 3 months, with inflammatory features, then I order labs and an x-ray of the pelvis. If the x-ray is consistent with sacroiliitis, then a diagnosis of AS can be made. Step 2. In patients without sacroiliitis on x-rays, but they have a positive HLA-B27, I look for 4 out of 11 spondylitis features to make the diagnosis. These 11 spondylitis features are inflammatory back pain, heel pain or enthesitis, saucy digits or dactylitis, eye inflammation or uveitis, a positive family history of AS, inflammatory bowel disease, alternating buttock pain, psoriasis, asymmetric arthritis, if they had positive response to NSAIDs, or elevated markers of inflammation, such as c-reactive protein. Once again, if the patient has 4 out of these 11 clinical features, then a diagnosis of AS can be made. Step 3. Patients that do not have radiographic sacroiliitis, but they have just 2 or 3 spondyloarthritis features and the positive HLA-B27, can be generally diagnosed with what we call non-radiographic axial spondyloarthritis. If the HLA-B27 is negative, then the likelihood to have this disease is very low. When suspicion is still high, then I order an MRI of the sacroiliac joints, and that will help me to make the diagnosis. Step 4. In patients without radiographic features and with 0 or only 1 spondyloarthritis feature, but still with a positive test of HLA-B27, I will evaluate him further with an MRI. If the MRI is positive, then it's enough for me to make the diagnosis. Once again, this will be called non-radiographic axial spondyloarthritis. I know it may sound a little complicated, so that is why I will always recommend to patients that have back pain to go and be evaluated by a rheumatologist that knows these diseases and recognizes and can treat you appropriately. If you like these educational videos, don't forget to hit the button below to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you, and I will see you soon.
Rheumatologistoncall.com